Can the quickest jets of the past outmaneuver the fastest spy plane ever built? In this episode, we're stepping into a chapter of aviation history that's as thrilling as a blockbuster movie. Picture the SR-71 Blackbird, a jet that zoomed across the skies so fast it could outrun the sun. Even after hanging up its wings over 24 years ago, this marvel of engineering still wears the crown as the fastest manned jet the world has ever seen. Since its first takeoff nearly 6 decades ago, nothing has managed to steal its thunder, not even close. And here's where it gets interesting. This jet was so slick it dodged more than 4,000 missiles like it was swerving to avoid potholes. Now, you might be wondering, with a bird this swift, how did America's top fighter jets, the F-14 Tomcat and the F-15 Eagle, even begin to catch up? Well, they had their work cut out for them, and today we're going to unwrap the story of how they tried to pin down the king of the. So buckle up, this ride through the clouds is about to get fascinating. The SR-71 Blackbird, a masterpiece of engineering. So, let's start with the mastermind behind the SR-71, Kelly Johnson. This wasn't his first rodeo. Johnson had already turned heads with his designs like the P-38 Lightning and the U-2 spy plane. But with the Blackbird, he really went all out. This jet wasn't just about going fast. It smashed records by hitting speeds of Mach 3.2 and could keep it up across distances that would leave other aircraft in the dust. What's wild is that it didn't just sprint. It ran marathons at speeds where others were gasping for air, and it was Johnson's knack for pushing the limits that made the SR-71 more than just another fast jet. It was a giant leap in aviation, but creating a jet that could travel faster than a rifle bullet wasn't just about drafting up some blueprints and hitting the assembly line. The challenges were as tough as making a smartphone the size of a credit card that could fold and fit into your wallet without a hitch. Engineers had to come up with wires that wouldn't melt from the sheer heat of flying that fast and hydraulic fluid that could work both on the ground and when cruising high above the clouds. And here's the interesting part. Most of this jet was built from titanium, a metal not just known for its sturdiness, but also for being hard to get. And guess where they got it from? None other than the Soviet Union, the very country the SR-71 would later keep an eye on. Talk about a bold move. They even had to design special quartz windows that wouldn't just turn into a sauna glass at high speeds, proving that when it comes to setting records, every tiny detail needs to be perfect. Stealth and speed, the Blackbird's clever tricks. Now let's dive into how the Blackbird managed to slip through enemy fingers with such finesse. While it wasn't stealth in the way we think of today's invisible jets, the SR-71 was sneaky in its own right. It wore a coat of special paint that helped it hide from radar, making it a slippery shadow in the skies. This jet was like a ghost that flew higher and faster than nearly anything else. It cruised at altitudes where even the fearsome Soviet MiG-25, which was no slouch in the speed department, couldn't hope to keep up, operating often 20,000 to 30,000 feet above its chasers. The Blackbird turned missile dodging into an art form, zipping past threats before they even realized it was there. It's no wonder that catching this bird was like trying to grab smoke with your bare hands. It was almost untouchable, challenging the champions, F-14 and F-15, take on the ultimate target. When it came time to really test the mettle of the US military's finest, the F-14 Tomcat and the F-15 Eagle, they didn't get an easy target. No, they were tasked with trying to tag the fastest bird in the sky, the SR-71 Blackbird. Imagine being a pilot in one of these fighter jets, and your training mission is to catch a jet that's pretty much a blur at best. The SR-71 served as the ultimate moving target, almost taunting the F-14 and F-15 with its blistering speed and sky-high flight path. To even stand a chance, the training scenarios had to be tweaked so the pilots weren't just tilting at windmills. The military adjusted the rules, sort of like lowering a basketball hoop so you can slam dunk, just to give these top guns a fighting shot at locking onto their elusive supersonic target. Training rules and realities, leveling the aerial playing field. In the high-stakes world of military training, sometimes you've got to change the game to make it fair, or at least fairish. Just like you might put some restrictions on a superstar athlete during practice to give others a chance to shine, the military often dials back on some of their most advanced equipment during exercises. Take the F-22 Raptors, for example. These jets are sometimes held back in their range or stealth capabilities to really test their pilots against older models. In the same vein, SR-71 pilots had to pull their punches in training missions. They didn't use their Blackbird's full speed or all of its stealth tricks, ensuring that F-14 and F-15 pilots could actually engage in a meaningful way. It wasn't about making it easy, but about making the training useful, giving these pilots a taste of chasing a near-untouchable target without making it downright impossible. Eagle versus Blackbird, the tactical dance. When the F-15 Eagles squared off against the SR-71 Blackbird, it was less of a chase and more of a high-altitude ballet where every move was calculated and every step was choreographed. The Eagles faced a steep challenge. Not only did they need to climb to dizzying heights to even see the Blackbird, but they also had to tweak their radars just to track it. Originally, their radars could only spot speeds up to 1,500 meters per hour, a crawl compared to the Blackbird zipping by at nearly 2,000 meters per hour. To give the Eagles a sporting chance, the SR-71 would sometimes throttle back to Mach 2.8 and fly along a path as predictable as a morning commute. This setup allowed the F-15 pilots to practice their intercepts without turning their training into an exercise in futility, giving them a glimpse of what it would be like to tangle with the fastest thing in the skies. The Tomcat's Edge, the Navy's F-14. Tomcat came to the game with some serious tech up its sleeves, boasting the formidable AAWG-9 radar and AIM-54 Phoenix missiles, which were like the sports cars of aerial combat, hitting speeds of Mach 4. This gear gave the Tomcat a leg up on paper, theoretically outpacing the Air Force's own F-15 Eagles when it came to hunting the elusive SR-71 Blackbird. But even with this advanced arsenal and tactics like keeping open lines for radio tips on where to find their swift quarry, Tomcat pilots quickly learned that theory and practice don't always line up. Despite their technological edge, the SR-71 remained a slippery foe, turning each training session into a high-speed game of tag where the Blackbird was always it and rarely caught. Conclusion, legacy, and lessons. The chase may have ended, but the lessons from the SR-71 Blackbird's dance with the F-14 Tomcats and F-15 Eagles continue to echo through the corridors of military strategy and aviation design. These high-speed, high-altitude training missions were more than just drills. They were pivotal in shaping the future of aerial combat and radar capabilities. As designers and strategists pored over the data from these engagements, they gleaned insights that would propel advancements in stealth technology and refine the aerodynamics of future fighters. The Blackbird might no longer grace the skies, but its influence soars on, steering the evolution of military aircraft and ensuring that its legacy is as enduring as the records it set. So, who had the better shot at taking down the SR-71? While the F-14 had advanced tech, the sheer speed and elusiveness of the Blackbird made it nearly untouchable. The debate over which aircraft could truly challenge the SR-71 remains a favorite topic among aviation enthusiasts. What do you think? Could modern technology have changed the outcome? Drop your thoughts in the comments below. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more thrilling explorations into military history.